بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كلامه المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن الذي كانوا يعملون صدق الله العظيم. Assalamu alaikum, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. Every single one of us would like to live a life that is uncomplicated, that is trouble-free, that is worrisome-free, that is effortless. Allah Azza wa Jal guarantees us this type of life in this world. I'm not speaking about the hereafter in Jannah. In this world, Allah Azza wa Jal guarantees us this type of life. And the verse of the Quran that I have recited in front of you from Surah An-Nahl, which is Surah number 16, verse number 97, Man amila salihan, speaks on exactly that topic, how we can achieve that effortless and worrisome free life. First of all, let us understand that every single one of us is surrounded by circumstances, our conditions. And we say life is full of ups and downs, but at times it feels like there are more downs than ups. Now, the point is that how do we change our circumstances? We have to first and foremost realize that Allah Azza wa Jal is Mughayyirul Ahwal. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who changes the circumstances. And He is Musabbibul Asbab. Yes, we are to adopt the means by which our circumstances will change from unfavorable to favorable. But let us not be in any doubt that it is Allah Azza wa Jal who is Musabbibul Asbab, who creates the means that which we can adopt to change our circumstances. And in the end, Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who changes, who holds the key to change our circumstances from unfavorable to favorable, or for that matter, from favorable to unfavorable. Now, to help us understand, let me give you an example. If a person has a vacuum cleaner and he is using his vacuum cleaner, he wants to shut off this vacuum cleaner. He wants to switch off this vacuum cleaner that is powered by electricity, by an electrical cord. What will he do? What can he do? Well, there's two ways to stop this vacuum cleaner. One is to try to stop the vacuum cleaner by jamming the roller, or by putting his hand or applying pressure to the roller. This, of course, is foolish. The easy way and the proper way to stop this vacuum cleaner is to use the on-off switch. Similarly, what happens is sometimes we spend our whole entire life trying to combat our situation, our circumstances, our unfavorable circumstances, without realizing that Allah Azza wa Jal is the on-off switch. We are trying to take on these circumstances head on. It is a head on collision, and we are trying to jam the roller and trying to stop the roller by use of force. This, of course, is foolish. The best way and the easiest way and the proper way and the simple way is to use the on off switch. We can try our whole entire life, from the time we reach puberty till our dying day, to change our circumstances, but ultimately it is Allah Azza wa Jal who will change our circumstances and bring upon favorable situations and circumstances. How? This ayah speaks to it. Man amila salihan, whoever does good. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying whoever does good deeds, righteous deeds, pious actions, those that are rewarding, then Allah Azza wa Jal says, min dhakarin aw untha, male or female, be that person a male or a female, man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha, falanuhyiyannahu hayatan tayyiba, but there is a condition, man amila salihan min dhakarin aw untha wa huwa mu'min, and he is a believer. So now we have two conditions. First is that he does good deeds, but this person who, male or female, who does good deeds should be a believer. So Iman and Amal al-Salih. And you will find these two, you will find this combo throughout the Quran, Iman and Amal al-Salih. Man amana wa amila salihan. Man alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat. Amanu wa amilu salihat. In Surah Al-Asr, wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat. Iman and Amal al-Salih. Iman and Amal al-Salih. So those same two conditions are mentioned in this verse. Man amila salihan, whoever does good, righteous deeds, min dhakarin aw untha, male or female, wa huwa mu'min, and that person, he or she, is a believer. Now, alhamdulillah, there is no doubt, there is not an iota of doubt that we are believers. We, alhamdulillah, are believers. We believe in Allah Azza wa Jal as our Rabb, as our Creator, as our Master. And we believe in the Akhirah. We believe in the everlasting eternal life that is to come. We believe in that day when we will rise up from our graves, shaking dirt from our hair, and we will be answerable to Allah Azza wa Jal. We believe in the prophethood and the Nubuwa of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that he is the last prophet. He is the seal of all prophets. We believe in the Quran. We have Iman, alhamdulillah, but that is only half of the equation. There is another half, that is to do good deeds. If a person, again, let me give you an example, because giving examples, taqrib ila al-faham, is easier to understand. If a person takes admission at the university and he pays the registration fee and he is registered in the university as a full-time student, but he also takes classes, he signs up for his classes, he has a full schedule, but he does not attend the classes, he does not attend any of the teacher's lectures, he does not turn in any of the assignments, and he does not take the test at the end of the semester. Now, even though he is registered as a full-time student, this student will not get a grade, a passing grade, he will not graduate. So the student has done the initial work. He has registered himself as a full-time student. But what about the work that comes after that? That is our example. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. We have done the initial work. We believe in Allah. We have Iman. But that is not the only condition in this verse. Allah azza wa jal is saying, Amila salihan. That person must also do good deeds. And that is where we find ourselves lacking. We focus on dunya, how to achieve dunya, how to acquire the worldly matter, and that is not prohibited as long as it is within halal means. But let us be very clear. Let us be very clear. And I'm not beating around the bush. I'm not mincing the words. There are two roadmaps in life. How to live our life, there are two ways, two distinct ways. قَدْ تَبَيَّنَ الرُّشْدُ مِنَ الْغَيْءِ فَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ Allah Azza wa Jal has shown us both of those ways, and they are distinct from each other as night and day. One roadmap in life is the one that is adopted by a disbeliever. And the other is the roadmap in life that is adopted by a believer. What is the disbeliever's way of living his life? His focus, his whole, all his entire focus and energy is directed towards one and one thing only, and that is how to amass wealth, how to procure wealth, how to earn as much wealth as possible. Why? So that he can buy the goods of this life. He can buy a better car, a fancier car, a bigger house. Why? So that he can be happy, he can enjoy life, and he can be happy. This will bring him joy and happiness in this world. Now, if a believer's roadmap in life is the same as a disbeliever, even though we say we believe in the Quran and we believe in this verse of the Quran, but if our roadmap in life is the same as a disbeliever, then we cannot expect any different results. If we want a troublesome free life, then our roadmap in life is different, which should be a'mal focused. It should not be focused on mal. It should be focused on a'mal. It should not be focused on wealth. It should be focused on good deeds, on a'mal, on filling our life with doing the best good deeds we can. What will happen? Why? Why? Because once we adopt a life full of a'mal, good deeds, then Allah Azza wa Jal will be happy. Allah Azza wa Jal will be pleased with us. And when Allah Azza wa Jal is pleased with us, then Allah Azza wa Jal will make our dunya better for us. Yes, not only our akhirah, but Allah Azza wa Jal will fix our worldly life for us. So you see, these are two very distinct ways the Sahaba Ikram, we find how they put a'mal, how they put the akhirah as a priority, how they made it a priority, and how they put it first, and they preferred the akhirah, and how Allah Azza wa Jal promised them the akhirah, the Jannah, but not only the akhirah, Allah Azza wa Jal fixed this world for them. During the time of Umar radiallahu an in Medina Munawwara, while he is Amirul Mu'mineen, there was so much wealth coming in that every person was assigned a stipend. Every person was assigned a stipend. But the rule was that an infant should have started eating solid food for that stipend to be assigned. So there were mothers who were trying to wean their babies off of the mother's milk so that the baby could start solid food. And sometimes the mothers were forcing their babies to take on solid food sooner than it was recommended for them. So why? Again, so that their babies could start receiving the stipend. Now, when Umar radiallahu anhu found out what mothers were doing, simply so that the babies could start receiving their monthly stipend the moment they started eating solid food, Umar radiallahu anhu said, "Oh my Allah, what have I done? What have I done?" Then the rule, the law was changed that as soon as a baby is born, a stipend will be assigned. Yes, as soon as that baby is born. That is how much wealth was pouring into Medina. This is why. Why? Because they put a'mal first. They put Allah Azza wa Jal first. They put akhirah, they put the hereafter first. And not only that, Allah Azza wa Jal will make our akhirah, He will make our dunya but Allah Azza wa Jal will start to love us. Yes. And when Allah Azza wa Jal loves us, then what happens? Then Allah Azza wa Jal, He calls Jibreel alayhi salam. In a hadith in Bukhari, da'a Jibreel. He calls Jibreel alayhi salam and announces to Jibreel alayhi salam that I love this person. You also love this person. This is Allah Azza wa Jal announcing to Jibreel alayhi salam Allah Azza wa Jal's love for this person who adopts an a life that a believer is to adopt. A life that puts the akhirah first. Allah Azza wa Jal announces His love in the heavens, and all the angels begin to love this person. All the heavenly creatures, creations of Allah, the angels begin to love this person. And then Allah Azza wa Jal invites Jibreel alayhi salam and makes that announcement to him. Jibreel alayhi salam comes down on earth and makes that same announcement. You and I cannot hear that announcement, but Allah Azza wa Jal appoints Jibreel to make that same announcement on earth. And when Jibreel alayhi salam makes that announcement on earth, ثُمَّ يُوضَعُ الْقُبُولُ فِي الْأَرْضِ, then this person is given acceptance in the world. Then the people begin to love this person. All the creations in the world begin to love this person. This is the life of a believer. Allah Azza wa Jal promises this life in Surah number 16, verse number 97. Man amila salihan, whoever does good, min dhakarin aw untha, male or female, wa huwa mu'min, and he or she is a believer, falanuhyiyannahu hayatan tayyiba, we will give him a good life. Allah Azza wa Jal is referring to this world, that we will give him a good life. We will give him a life free of troubles and free of difficulties and worries. We will give him a life that is effortless. We will give him a life that is uncomplicated. And then what else? وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ. This verse continues. وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ. We will reward him أجرهم his reward in the hereafter بأحسن الذي كانوا يعملون with the best of what he used to do. This ayah gives us a lot of hope because Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying that in the hereafter we will reward him with the best of what he used to do. In other words, again, to help us understand an example of a student in a university, if he takes four exams and on one exam he scores an A, on the next one he scores a B, on the next one he scores a C, and then on the fourth one he gets an F. Now out of these four, he only aced one of them. But the professor says, you know what? This one test that you have taken in which you received an A, this test shows me your full potential. So you know what I'm going to do? I am going to score an A. I'm going to give you an A on all four of your tests. That of course does not happen in this world, but that is what Allah Azza wa Jal will do. He will look at all our good deeds and all our amal, and he will say, you know what? This is the best you have done. It was full of ikhlas, filled with sincerity. And you know what? The others, some of those good deeds might have been lacking in some areas in sincerity or in concentration and devotion. But I'm going to take your best salat. I'm going to take your best sadaqah. I'm going to take your best fasting and reward all your salat, all your sadaqah, your charity, your donations, and your fasting with the best of what you have done in this world. That is how Allah Azza wa Jal will recompense us in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq, the ability to practice what has been said and heard. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وما علينا إلا البلاغ. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. صلي على محمد. السلام عليك يا رسول الله. السلام عليك يا حبيبي يا نبي الله. السلام عليك يا رسول الله. السلام عليك يا حبيبي يا نبي الله يا رسول الله.